What's up, familia? My name is Hugo Fernandez, founder of Just Digital Inc. and author of The Client Acquisition Blueprint. And in today's video, I have a very simple message, and that is to take full responsibility for your life, for your business, and take charge. Don't be somebody that just sits there and waits for this thing to clear, waits for things to pick back up, for the businesses to open, for you to get your job back if unfortunately you lost your job. Today, April 2nd, the unemployment numbers, not unemployment, the jobless claim numbers came out, and they're at 6.6 million people for the past week alone. 6.6 million people lost their job and filed for unemployment last week. The week before that was already a record. It was a 10x increase from the week before that. It was a 3.28 million people that filed for unemployment. Take those 2 weeks combined, now we're talking about 10 million people who lost their job. And that is extremely sad. That, to put it into perspective, is the total, about the total number. It almost equals what happened in 08 and 09 in over a year. So in 2 weeks, yesterday I made a video on the two trends that I'm seeing going on. Trends are accelerating and things are being magnified so much. And this is a perfect example. In 2 weeks, the total number of people who lost their jobs was equal to the worst financial crisis since the Great Depression. Just let that sink in. In 2008, 2009, the world seemed to be crashing down. Everything was upside down, and a lot of people lost their jobs. A lot of people were financially hurt. Now you take that and compress it in 2 weeks, that's what we're seeing here. So my message for you is the news is gonna continue to get, unfortunately, worse here in the next couple of weeks. And as entrepreneurs, as leaders, we have to take full responsibility and full on charge to really look at our businesses, look at what was wrong, what's broken, what we can fix, and then take action. Don't wait for the government to see if you're gonna be approved. I know some of my business owner friends try to apply for the disaster loans or the payment protection loans, and these are good loans. These are, you know, I'm grateful that they're there, but you can't spend all your energy waiting by the phone or by your inbox to see if something's gonna happen. I know a lot of businesses also stopped advertising, stopped marketing, cut off people, just started going, to be honest, a little bit crazy in terms of cutting off a lot of stuff. And that, I get it. Look, I get it. You're scared. You have to figure out how you're gonna make it through these next couple of weeks or months, but this is not gonna go away. This isn't gonna change in 2 weeks. This is something that we're in for the long haul. So take full responsibility, bet on yourself, and figure out what can I do today to set myself up for success in the future. And I have a couple of quick little suggestions on how to do that on a business level. But as a business, here's what I did. As soon as I realized, hey, this is something that's gonna affect our business for not only for the next couple of weeks and months, but for the rest of 2020. The whole plan that I had going into the year, that one got put on the shelf, put on hold, and I created a new 2020 recession game plan. And I created a document with my team of all the different initiatives that we could take, all the different value that we could bring to the marketplace, what we were going to do from a financial standpoint, from a products and services standpoint, from every angle, and what we could all do to chip in, right? So I created a running Google Doc, and I made a list of all the skills that we didn't have that we needed to pick up. And some of those skills are quick, right? Hey, I need to learn X software, or I need to figure out how to do this other thing over here. So some of those are quick. A lot of those are longer term, right? How do we pivot to selling to a different demographic? How do we create a new product to bring to the marketplace? How do we take all the stuff that we did in the past and expand it, 10x it, so that we can bring it to the marketplace today, right? So made a list of all the stuff that we could do proactively for the future. I also made a list of, I did a basic SWOT analysis. What are our strengths? What are our weaknesses? What are our opportunities? And what are the threats? The threats are pretty obvious right now. Don't spend too much time on that because those will be pretty apparent. The strengths, you have to double down on your strengths. Weaknesses, figure out where your vulnerabilities are. Right now is a perfect time to strengthen up those weaknesses, or at least be aware so you're not blindsided, right? So a weakness could be, hey, we were relying too much on face-to-face, or we were relying too much on one advertising channel. So figure out what those are for you. Run a basic SWOT analysis and make a list of what you're going to do and get a game plan going. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you do have to have some sense of an idea of where you're going. Hopefully this is just a reminder and you already did that, but if you haven't, you got to do it now. The second thing is you have to shift your focus from all the negative and everything that's going on. That's real. That's one version of reality, right? What you see on the news and the 10 million people who lost their job, that's one version of reality. And I don't want to dismiss that. And I can empathize with the people going through that. But there's this other beautiful, amazing side of the world that you can shift your focus. And that beautiful, amazing side is actually much bigger than the catastrophe that's going on over here. There's people stepping up. There's companies changing their entire operations to produce more healthcare products. There's people doing more virtual and remote, obviously. Even if it's like, hey, even if the negative is like, I can't see my family, what we did last weekend was we got together with all of our family, put them all on a Zoom call, and just had a little party. And we just started dancing in our living room, and it was cool. We tossed everybody up on the TV, and we had a great time. That was my wife's idea. And you got to shift your focus to the positive. And also, you have to figure out, who do I want to follow today? A lot of gurus are being exposed for a lot of things, and I get it. Look, everybody's scared, and you can visually see it in some of these gurus that, you know, they're unfortunately, they were on shaky ground and now they're paying the price. So be very, very careful with who you listen to, whose advice you listen to. But once you find people that you like, it doesn't have to be me. If you're still watching this, thank you. But it doesn't have to be me. It doesn't have to be anybody that's already out there. Find a voice of reason and a voice of positivity and somebody who can say, hey, here's what I'm doing. Here's where I'm going. Let's go. Right? I don't know if it's going to work, but let's go. There's a lot of uncertainty. You need to follow people who have certainty and people who, even if they don't have it all figured out, that have a positive attitude. So shift your focus from the negative, because again, that's one version of reality. Shift your focus to the positive. And the third and final thing is you got to keep moving. You got to keep moving. You got to keep moving. You have to take little steps and big steps to keep your business and your life moving forward. Don't sit watching the news. Definitely read what you need to read, but don't just wait for your stimulus check to come in the mail. Because to be honest, it could be weeks, it could be months. Nobody freaking knows. Like, people are still releasing these details. They're still trying to figure it out. And to be honest, you have your future and your dreams. What you do today is gonna affect you for the next few years, the next, even at the very least, the next few months. And look, we have the rest of the year. This is the new reality. The sooner we can accept that, great. I've accepted it, and we're just figuring out, what do we do to move forward? Get a game plan going, follow the right people, feed yourself the right information, and just keep moving. Don't stand still. The definition of a recession is a contraction in economic activity. What that means is there's just not enough people buying and selling, right? Buying and selling. And so what you need to do is you need to increase your output, increase your economic activity, increase the stuff, increase the positivity. Even if it's just a positivity, call your family, tell them you love them. Just do something, take action, and move your business, your life forward. I hope you found this video helpful. And look, I'm going to be producing more of these videos. Leave me a comment below. How are you adjusting? Who is somebody that you're following that you think we should follow, that you think I should follow? And where do you get your information from? What is your recession game plan? Leave me a comment below. I'm going to be trying to, my whole goal here in the next month, I mean, I'm locked up at home anyway, like the rest of us, is to shoot more videos, point you in the right direction. I've been an entrepreneur for the better part of a decade now, and I have employees. I've run and started multiple businesses, and I find myself in a fortunate position where my business isn't shut down, where my business is still able to produce revenue, serve value. And I also realize that it's important to have more of these types of conversations. So if you appreciate it, give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment below, follow me on social, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow me on LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, and I look forward to helping you get through this, and hopefully with a big smile and with a lot of positivity throughout all this, because look, it's gonna pass and you're gonna make it through.